In this video, we're going to complete the CUDA software, Infinite Pre-Algebra Free Worksheet, Classifying Solids. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free CUDA software website worksheet. Now, our instructions for this entire worksheet are to name each figure, and there's a couple different types of figures that we'll go over. So before we dive into this worksheet, let's go over a couple different types of figures that we'll encounter. One big category of figures are prisms. Prisms have two flat bases and the rest of the sides are all rectangles, or sometimes squares in the instance of a cube. But remember, squares are just specific types of rectangles. There are also cylinders, and cylinders are similar to the prisms in the fact that they have two flat bases, but those bases are circles, which leaves the figure with only one other smooth side. Then we go into pyramids, where pyramids have one flat base and the rest of the sides are all triangles. That's the easiest way to identify a pyramid. And a cone is closely related to the pyramid in the fact that it has one flat base and that base is round like a circle. So let's go ahead, jump into this worksheet, and we'll learn even more details about classifying solids. Now, in number one, right away, we'll be able to figure out what it is. It has a flat base here, which I'll shade in. Then it has a flat base on the other side. If I outlined that, you'd be able to see the other flat base. Those are the bases because they're the same exact shape, connected by faces that all form what shape? Rectangles. So we know that this is a prism. But we have to figure out what kind of prism it is. Notice that's where the base comes into play. The base has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides on the base. And a five-sided figure we know is a pentagon. So this is labeled as a pentagonal prism, where this is a description of the base and this is the description of the three-dimensional figure. It's a pentagonal prism. And number two, let's figure out what we have. Again, I can see two bases in this figure. If we look on the left-hand side, here's our base. And directly opposite that is the other base, which leaves us with rectangles as the rest of our sides. It's almost like if you can envision, if we were to draw one of these bases and just pull that base straight out of our paper, extending it up, this is the figure that will form. We know it's a prism because of the rectangular sides. Now we just have to figure out exactly what kind of prism it is. So let's look at the base. The base has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. So again, that's a pentagon. So we have a pentagonal prism. Let's move on to number three. In number three, this figure actually has all sides that are rectangles. So we know at least two of the bases are rectangles and all the other sides are rectangles. And if we look at this label of the base, we know it's a rectangle because the opposite sides are congruent, marked by those lines. So this side is congruent to this side, and this side is congruent to this side. If all four sides were the same length or congruent, then we would have a square, not a rectangle. But because all the sides are rectangles, we know, first of all, it's a prism, and the base is a rectangle, so it's a rectangular prism, because the base helps us define the type of prism. So let's move on to number four. And number four, right away I see a bunch of sides that are rectangles. So let's look at the bases. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. A six-sided figure is a hexagon, so this is a hexagonal prism. let's move on to number 5. And in number 5, we mix it up a bit, because I don't see a single rectangle on this entire figure. Remember those two special kinds of figures that I mentioned that had round bases or circular bases? One of them was cone, and one of them was a cylinder. A cylinder had two round bases, whereas a cone only has one round base. So we know this is a cone because it comes together at a point with a round base. This kind of looks like an upside down ice cream cone if we think about it. So that's one way to know that this is a cone. And number 6, again, I don't see a bunch of rectangles. I do, however, see a lot of triangles, 4 different triangles to be exact, and those triangles meet together at a point. So I know I'm working with a pyramid, but similar to a prism, we have to figure out what type of pyramid, and that's decided by the base. The base we have is a square because all 4 sides are congruent. So this figure is a square pyramid. In number 7, right away, we see that we have one round circle, and the rest of that figure comes together in a point. So we know, because we have a circle base, we know that it's either going to be a cylinder or a cone, and there's only one base, so we know it's a cone. And number 8, we're back to the prisms because we have rectangles for our sides. And let's see how many sides our base has. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And directly opposite that is our other base that will have the same number of sides. 6. So a 6-sided figure is a hexagon. So this is a hexagonal prism. Let's continue on to the next page. In the next page, we're dealing with another, what? Pyramid or a prism? It's a prism because we have rectangles as the sides. And another way to think about what kind of prism it is, we can just count the number of rectangles and that will equal the number of sides on our base. So 1, 2, 3, 4, there's 5 different rectangles that form our sides. A 5-sided figure is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, a pentagon. So we know that we are dealing with a pentagonal prism. In number 10, right away, our sides aren't rectangles, our sides are triangles, and they come together at a point. Let's count the sides of the base so we know what kind of pyramid we have. Or we can count how many triangles come from the same point, and that's also going to give us the number of sides on our base. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that base is a hexagon, which makes this a hexagonal pyramid. Moving on to number 11, we can tell we're dealing with another pyramid because we have sides that are not rectangles, but we have lots of sides that are triangles. We just need to count the sides of the base. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sides to this base. So this is, again, a hexagonal pyramid. A number 12. All my sides are rectangles, so I know I'm dealing with a prism. And because every single side is a rectangle, I know that my base is also a rectangle. So this is a rectangular prism. In number 13, I have a bunch of sides that are triangles that come together at a point. So I just have to figure out the number of sides on my base to figure out what type of pyramid I have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sides for the base. So this is, again, a hexagonal pyramid. And number 14, right away, we have a special kind of figure because we have 2 bases and both the bases are round. circles. So two bases that are round, that's going to be a cylinder. Many people like to think of cylinders as cans. So a cone you can envision as an ice cream cone, whereas a cylinder you can envision as a can, like a can of beans. That can forms a cylinder. And number 15, I have triangles for my sides that come together at a point, and I have a rectangular base. So this is going to be a rectangular pyramid. And lastly on this worksheet, I'm ending with a pyramid because I have sides that are triangles that come together at a point. And for my base, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. Five-sided figure is a pentagon. So having a pentagon as a base and being a pyramid, we classify this as a pentagonal pyramid. And that wraps up our classifying solids worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Or if you want more in-depth explanation, check out my tutorial page. You can find more videos on my YouTube channel, on my website, maemap.com, that's maemap.com, and don't forget to support me. Click on the links below to find out more information. But as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.